13 and claims she only exists in the mind of a higher being. And I enjoy his work, mostly scenic landscapes, but each one is focused on an easel where the man paints himself, painting himself and all that's in his visual field. He said this was the only way he could make himself real. Ever since he could remember, he had one nightmare reoccur, but until about 10 years ago it didn't matter. It consisted of loud distorted sounds echoing off the concrete he ran on top of in an attempt to reach a ladder. Now sometimes he gets so close but never touches destination, which caused him much frustration cause he didn't know what it meant. And by the end of the dream he saw the scene from a bird's eye, only to witness his dead body laying on the cement. It was only to witness his dead body laying on the cement. At first it freaked him out, but after a while he grew content. So he thought it's just a dream and kept living his life, writing his soul on the canvas cause it sheds its planet light. And it goes on and on like space and time, ain't nothing odd. It's not that he didn't believe, he just didn't approve of God. His experience was one I couldn't comprehend till I stopped being detective and listened to him as a friend. He said he once saw a painting that told his whole life story. It was then that he knew he was the art of divinity. He once saw a painting that told his whole life story. A brush stroke of the gods made him one note in their symphony. He once saw a painting that told his whole life story. He spoke for himself and not the rest of humanity. He once saw a painting that told his whole life story. And I realized that I'm not real, God just imagined. I said about 10 years ago, the event that changed his whole reality took place on his monthly trip to the local art gallery. It was there where he studied his contemporaries, and there where he nearly carried his sanity to a home and buried it. It was a very mysterious day. The place was almost empty and he got chills down his spine just being present in the scene. On the wall there was a picture that looked familiar, and when he got close his heart stopped. What he saw was a painting of his dream. It was a painting of his dream. His body on a runway by a ladder to an airplane with his propeller spinning, which accounted for the loud noise. The matchup was perfect, and that was the day he stopped believing in existence. He resented his creator. I mean, words can't explain what must have went on in his brain while he stared into a frame of a work of art which he created and was at the same time. The mind can't handle that much, it's just insane. It's like reading a book with each word describes your thoughts, and in quotations it reads whatever you say when you talk. You think it can't happen, but it did happen. I guess there's surprisingly wide cracks in each life's sidewalk. He stumbled upon an answer when he never had a question, and decided to stop dreaming to maintain his mental health. Now he hardly talks to people. Stays in his basement, writing in infinity by painting himself, painting himself. This is a strange universe. Is it all just a blueprint in the real universe? Is my consciousness useless? Are we really something? A higher intelligence made up, a figment of imagination colored by a cosmic paintbrush? Maybe all of our art creates the fate of other beings. Then every character in every novel thinks it's alive. We're just gods ruling blind. I don't know what it means, but that's the story of the man who trained himself not to dream. He once saw a painting that told his whole life story. He witnessed the paradox of the word existing. He once saw a painting that told his whole life. He colored his world theirs and concluded he wasn't living. He once saw a painting that told his whole life story. The hidden variable that all that is art. And when I close my eyes, I see eternity as a story. A god imagined the god that imagined me. And I am God. And so on, so on, and so on.